नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई जेवियन इंदु, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड एथोलॉजी, जयोति विद्यापीठ, विमेंस यूनिविर्सिटी. टूडे आई विल डिस्कस द ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल ड्रॉ द ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम. So students, this is the block diagram of computer system in which we are using input output devices, memory and processor. Processor means a chip. Here I wrote MUP. MUP means microprocessor. Input output devices used to give the inputs and produce the outputs. Why we are using input output devices here? Input output devices are used to give inputs and produce outputs. Like input output devices, the examples of input output devices are keyboard, mouse, monitor, printer. These are the input output devices which we will use to give the inputs and produce the output. Next section is the memory. We know very well, memory is used to store programs, data in the form of 0, 1, and this is the block for processor. So you can see from here that processor can control memory and IO devices. But memory and IO devices cannot control each other. Only processor can control memory and input output devices. You can see from here that there is no connection between memory and IO devices, but there is a connection between processor and memory and processor and IO devices. Now, so now we will discuss that how memory will store any program in the form of 1 and 0, because we know that computer understand only machine language. Suppose we type from the keyboard A equals to B plus C, but A equals to B plus C directly can't store in the memory, because in the memory the storage will be in the form of 0 and 1. So first of all, we have to convert A equals to B plus C in the form of 0, 0s and 1s. Let's take an example. Suppose we write A equals to B plus C in the higher level language, like in C, C++, we write A equals to B plus C. And in the assembly level language, we write add B, comma C. So in the assembly language, in the assembly language, suppose we want to add B and C. So we will write ADD, means add B comma C. But in the higher level language, if we want to add two numbers, then we will write A equals to B plus C. Here A contains the sum of B and C, and add B comma C means here adding the B and C. So in the higher level language, in C, C++, we write in this form. And in the assembly language, if you want to add two numbers, then we will write like this. After this, what we will do? A equals to B plus C directly can't store in the memory, because first of all, we have to convert this into the binary form, means in the form of 0 and 1. So in the higher level language, to convert a program into the machine language, we will use compiler. Convert a program which is written in the form of assembly higher level language, we will use compiler to convert it into the machine language. This is the machine लैंग्वेज और यू कैन से दैट दिस इज द बाइनरी language. So students, in the higher level language, to convert a program into the binary language or machine language, we will use compiler. The basic purpose of the compiler is convert the higher level language program into the machine language. Now suppose A equals to B plus C, compiler converted it into the 00 in the form 00. So this 00 can store in the memory. So compiler is a software, you can say that it is a program which are converting the higher level language program into the machine language or binary language program. Next, when we write the program in the assembly language, to convert a program which is written in the assembly language into the machine language, we will use assembler. What we will use? Assembler. Assembler is also a software, or you can say that it is a program which is used to convert the assembly language program into the machine language. So now this form can store in the memory. So first of all, we will draw the block diagram of computer system in which input output devices, memory, processor we will use. After that, first of all, input devices will give the input and output devices will produce the output. In the memory, data can store only in the form of 0 and 1. But first of all, we have to convert our program into the machine language or binary language. So if program is in higher level language, then we will use the compiler. And if program is in the assembly language, then we will use the assembler to convert the program into the machine language. Students, always remember, compiler is not used to check the errors. The main purpose of the compiler is only to convert the machine, to convert a higher level language program into the machine language. If error comes, then it will not compile the program further. So today we discussed the block diagram of computer system. I hope you are satisfied with my today's digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment section. Thank you.